And hello from Philadelphia. Frank here with yet another episode of UFO News Network Sunday. Well, we're in the final countdown. If the UFO report from the military and intelligence agencies drop within the allotted time frame, that will be within the next 2 weeks. So let's take a closer look at this countdown. Will we see it on time? Will it be early? Will it be late? Well, let's go over a couple of quick things. Firstly, President Biden is over in Europe. He's at the G7 conference, and he's going to be staying in Europe until next Wednesday. So he's going to be meeting with Vladimir Putin at that point. So I don't think this report is going to be dropped before he gets back. So I certainly don't expect it to happen next week at all. So I don't think the report will come out for those reasons. I think the government's coordinated enough. They're not going to drop this UFO stink bomb. And I'll get into some more reasons why I consider that to be the case. We go further along, but this UFO stink bomb is not going to be dropped while he's at the G7. It's not going to be dropped while he's meeting with Putin. So we're looking at him meeting with Putin next Wednesday. So, you know, then he's got to come back. He's probably got, he's an older guy. He's got to rest up a little bit. So I don't expect it to come out at all. I'd be shocked if it came out at all next week. And really, the week after, that is the week. That is the deadline. The week ending on Friday, the 25th, that's your deadline. So will we see it that week? Well, there's a couple reasons that I think we will. Number one, it's the deadline. Now, Marco Rubio has in the past said that these types of reports, they're often delayed. They're often not on time, so it's no big deal. He said that in one of the early interviews that he gave. Well, this report's a little bit different. Number one, it's already gotten some significant media attention. So I don't think they'll want to delay this report, really. Also, the New York Times leakage of some details that the report's, it sounds like it's pretty well done. They might have to do some edits, change some things here and there. But I think the body, the overwhelming majority of the report is finished. And they just have to go through a few quick things. It's probably finished right now. That would be my guess. And that they're just waiting for the best moment as far as they're concerned, when it's most advantageous to them to get it out there. And like I said, I don't think for the reasons that I already discussed with Biden, his first trip overseas, he's first G7 summit, first summit with Putin, and he's going to have to come back the 17th, and he's going to want to bask in the glory of his being a world leader for a little bit. So I don't think that we'll see it next week. Then we're looking at the week of the 21st. Actually, I think it'll just come out right on time. You know, that's what I'm thinking right now. It'll come out on time. The day is the 25th, so it might come out a day early, might come out a couple days early, but I think they'll get it out then. The reason why, again, I don't think it'll be delayed. Okay, you're looking at the next week is a holiday week. It's a 4th of July weekend coming up. So I don't think they'll release this UFO stink bomb report on the 4th of July weekend. And they can't hold it too much because the press is starting to pressure them a little bit. In fact, more than a little bit on the report's release. So it's got to come out eventually. They'll pick what they think is the most opportune time to do it. And my thinking is that worked out pretty nicely that the 180 days is up this next coming week. So I think that it'll come out on time. That's what I'm thinking. I could be wrong. Again, I'm not predict. I predict I'd be shocked if it comes out at all next week. And then the week after, they start delaying things and get it into the holiday. And then they're looking at if they wait past the holiday, they're looking at a 10-day, 2-week, or maybe longer delay. And that's just going to ratchet up the attention that I don't think that these guys want. And again, again, I'll go into more details about why that is as it comes out. So yeah, I do think that's what we have coming. I think it'll be, if I had to put a dollar on it, I would bet on time, not early and not too late for the reasons that I outlined. It seems like that's a nice little window there, that week ending in the 25th. That's a nice little window for them to finally get this thing out. And, you know, they got to release the stink bomb. And I think it's looking to me like that's the best opportunity for them to do it. So there's that. And then we've also got talking a little bit more detail about the contents. So we know that there are 120 cases there, give or take, are going to be covered in the report, and mostly apparently they're from the Navy based on the New York Times reporting from a week or so ago, and we'll see how that goes. But again, you know, Rubio had stated a while back that he wants to know what they are, and I want to know what happened at Stephenville. I want to know what that was. It'll be very interesting to see the level of the Air Force contribution to this report in general, and specifically, will that case even be mentioned? As you know, I've gone over here on this show ad infinitum, I don't want to repeat it all over again, but basically you've got confirmed several ground witnesses seeing this very unusual UFO in the Stephenville, Erath County, Texas area back in 2008. A radar report FOIA'd out that indicates a fast-moving 1,900 to 2,000 mile an hour UFO traveling over that area with a size estimated at a minimum based on the radar reports of 500 feet. Follow-up from the ATIP program when it was operational. They were able to track down the identity of two pilots, two F-16 Air Force pilots who chased this particular object, and the pilots gave them the brush. They stonewalled them. They would not talk to ATIP because they said that they had signed non-disclosure agreements with who? We don't know. What they encountered, we don't know, but we want to know. I don't want to know what they are. I want to know what that was. So that's that. Let's move forward to our next topic. So within the last week or so, Sam Harris, who's regarded as something of an intellectual in some circles, has started talking in detail about UFOs and what he was thinking about it. And he seems to be rather convinced that we are actually on the verge of some sort of disclosure. You know, I hope he's right about that. He does seem to be wrong about a few things. He's you know, an atheist who argues with various religious folks about their religion and points out how terrible they are, Christianity, Islam, and all that. You know, basically, that was the sort of thing I was doing when I was 12. You know, so now I'm on this. So what are you going to do about that? He has made some interesting comments. Apparently, he has been reached out to. He has a big following, and they think that apparently some people are reaching out to him who are a little bit more clued in about the UFO stuff and trying to persuade him to be something of a thought leader on this issue, apparently. So let's go to some of Sam's comments, and we've got those lined up here, and let's give a listen to what Sam is saying about UFO stuff.
There's no telling what spooky things may in fact be true. I mean, I don't know if you've been on the receiving end of, you know, recent rumors about our conversation about UFOs very likely changing in the near term, right? But like, yeah. There was just a Washington Post article and a New Yorker article, and you know, I've received some private outreach, and perhaps you have. I know other people in our orbit have people who are claiming that the government has known much more about UFOs than they have let on until now. And this conversation is about to become more prominent, you know, yes. And it's not going to be whatever, you know, whoever's left standing when the music stops. It's not going to be a comfortable position to be in as a, you know, super rigorous scientific skeptic saying there's no there, who's been saying there's no there there for the last.
Well, let's stop that right there, because I think that's a rather telling comment, a rather interesting. because what Harris seems to be saying here, and I might be wrong about this, but what Harris seems to be saying here is the biggest problem with disclosure is that a lot of the intelligentsia, a lot of scientists, a lot of quote-unquote intelligent people are going to look stupid with all that. And I say, if that's the biggest problem with disclosure, let her rip. That's not a problem. That's icing on the cake. It's always nice to see a lot of pompous, full of themselves intellectual types get deflated. So if that's the biggest problem with disclosure, disclose, baby, because again, it's icing on the cake, not a problem. But let's keep going and listen to the rest of what he has to say here.
75 years, right? You know, the short version is, it sounds like the Office of Naval Intelligence and the Pentagon are very likely to say to Congress at some point in the not too distant future that we have evidence that there is technology flying around here that seems like it can't possibly be of human origin. Right. Now, I don't know what I'm going to do with that kind of disclosure. Right. Maybe it's going to be nothing. No follow on conversation to really have. But that is such a powerfully strange circumstance to be in. Right. I mean, it's just, what are we going to do with that? If, in fact, that's what happens. Right. If, in fact, the considered opinion, despite the embarrassment it causes them, of.
That's that he does make an interesting point there, the embarrassment that it causes them. I'm going to get into more of that later in the show, but let's continue on with Sam.
The U.S. government, of all of our intelligence, all of the relevant intelligence services, is that this isn't a hoax. There's too much data to suggest that it's a hoax. We've got too much radar imagery. There's too much satellite data, whatever data they actually have. There's too much of it. All we can say now is something's going on, and there's no way it's the Chinese or the Russians or anyone else's technology. That should arrest our attention, you know, collectively to a degree that nothing in our lifetime has. And now
the other shoe hasn't quite dropped here, but there was recently an article in the Washington Post. This may have been covered many other places, but I saw it there. That the Office of Naval Intelligence and the Pentagon are scheduled to brief Congress about the wealth of data that the government has on UFOs.
All right.
Right.
Okay, this is from a second show where he's talking about this. I guess this is his own show where he's talking about this. The first part of the interview or the first interview was with Lex Fridman. This is from his own show where he co-hosts with one of the unfunniest people on planet Earth, Ricky Gervais. So let's listen into what he has to say here.
And stuff leaked or was leaked purposely during this last year. And got surprisingly little attention, but the rumors that I've heard, and again, this is still just in the mode of rumors, but perhaps soon to be confirmed, is that our intelligence services and the Pentagon are going to tell Congress that this is real, right? This is a real phenomenon, right? It's not that UFOs have been explained to the satisfaction of the government. On the contrary,
they'd have to change their name.
They have seen that there's technology that really can't be of human origin, right? They don't think this is the Chinese or the North Koreans or some other part of human society producing technology that is strange, and they can't write it off as anomalies of perception. I mean, there's just too much radar data. There's too much satellite imagery at this point. And the stuff they're sitting on that's top secret is much better than anything that's been leaked out. This is probably premature to even talk about this, but, you know, I have someone reached out to me and has assured me that, you know, I'm going to be on a Zoom call with, you know, former heads of, you know, the CIA and Office of Naval Research and people, you know, whose bona fides are very easy to track. And they're concerned about the messaging around all of this to the public and dampening down panic and conspiracy theories.
Well, I'm going to jump in here and say I don't doubt for a second that somebody reached out to Sam and told him that. Not sure about this Zoom call with former Intel chiefs. Somebody might be pulling his leg a little bit here. Maybe not. Maybe he got the straight dope. We'll get into a little bit more of that in the next segment. But let's keep going with Sam.
What is being promised here is a disclosure that is, frankly, either the most alarming or the most interesting thing in the world, depending on your how you take it. But it's not a representation of the facts that will give scientific skeptics any comfort. And that's just, you know, we're faced with the prospect of having to apologize to the people we've been laughing at for the last 50 years who...
Well, there we go. And apology accepted, Sam. No problem there. You know, yeah, we were ahead of the curve on this. Sorry about that, everybody who made fun of people who were into UFOs or dismissed it out of hand or didn't pay any attention to it. You had your chance. What can I tell you? But those are Sam's comments. Again, he's kind of a controversial guy. I don't really have any problem with what he's saying here. Like I said about that Zoom call, I think somebody might be... pulling his leg. Maybe not, but at least I hold that out as a possibility. And generally speaking, his comments on UFOs are okay, except for the part that I think he betrays a truly elitist attitude by saying the biggest problem with all this is that some smart people are going to get embarrassed. Well, boo-hoo. And there's another fellow who runs around in these intellectual circles named Eric Weinstein. And he is spending most of his time on Twitter, really engaging people pretty aggressively. He is a mathematician and runs Thiel Capital, an investment firm, is the managing director of that. And he's also, one of these online guys, thought influencers and so on and so forth. So he's another one of these guys. Gravitate around roughly the circle, the Jordan Peterson types, the Ben Shapiro types, intellectuals who maybe lean a little bit to the right in terms of a lot of their attitudes. But by and large, if you want to jump in, you're more than welcome to do it. To be honest with you, just having a big audience isn't that big a deal, to tell you the truth. Demi Lovato has a big audience, too, and, welcome her, and some of her ideas about society in general seem a little bit better than at least Harris's in terms of her support for gay rights and anti-bullying and her contributions to various worthy causes. I hold her, at least as a person, in a little bit higher regard than I do Harris, welcome aboard. That's all I can say about that, and let's get to our final topic of the day. One of the interesting things and one of the great things about being a UFO researcher is that lots of different people from lots of different professional backgrounds are getting to the point where they're talking credibly about UFOs. And it's interesting to get their perspective and bring their skill sets to the table and offer up their interpretations. Don't agree with all of them. But this one in particular was pretty interesting. Now, within the past week, this link to this YouTube video was posted in one of the UFO groups over at Facebook. And initially, I was very skeptical. It's by a group of former government intel analysts who focus on body language. And they've got a pretty good following at YouTube. I've never heard of the guys before, but they've got a good following over there. And it's four of them. And basically, what they do is they look at videos of people being interviewed, and they analyze their body language. Now, I've always been a little skeptical. I'm actually skeptical about most things. I think perhaps because I'm a UFO buff you wouldn't think that. But actually, I'm really skeptical. I came into all this pretty skeptical, but the information that I was able to turn up satisfied me, and the rest is history. But as far as these guys go... They are body language analysts, among other things, apparently, but they also do this. I've always been skeptical of this process. It's hardly a science, maybe a little bit of an art form, just reading people. But these guys did an entire video, and it's a long one. I'm obviously not going to play the same thing. I'm going to post the link, so if you want to, you can go over. But like I said, I went in skeptical, and the full video is an hour and 40 minutes long. And I ended up watching the whole thing, not in one sitting. I had to do this and do that, so it took me a little while to get through the whole thing. But actually, I was pretty fascinated. What they did was they took various interviews with key public figures. You're talking about presidents. You're talking about former directors of intel agencies, those level guys. They took those interviews and basically went through each one. They played them, and then they analyzed what the body language was saying. So this is one. This is an interview that was done on Meet the Press with Leon Panetta. And he's a former CIA director, former Secretary of Defense, and he's asked about UFOs, and because the reason I picked this one is basically because this is one that I missed. It's one that we never got a chance to listen to and go back over. And I have to tell you, the comments from these guys are very telling. And going forward, I might learn a little bit about body language and do some body language reading myself. Basically, when we've played those videos of guys like Brennan and Obama and Biden, when we've played those videos, I just sort of analyzed what I was looking at and what I heard. Basically, what I heard and what I saw. These guys look at things a little bit differently, and here's what they saw. So let's run this clip with Leon Panetta and their analysis, and then I'll talk about their analysis afterwards. I'll analyze their analysis.
When you've seen this unidentifiable stuff, is your presumption that it is a China or a Russia testing some crazy technology that we somehow don't have, or are we sort of over assuming the abilities of China and Russia, and that the only other explanation is, if it is not us ourselves, that it's something otherworldly?
Well, Chuck, it's obviously been going on for a long time, and there's a lot of speculation. I've never seen any evidence that any of this is related to extraterrestrial human beings or beings of any kind. And for that reason, I've always thought that even though we have these sightings, and I guess the report that's coming out is going to basically acknowledge that there are a lot of sightings, they haven't tied it to being UFOs in the sense of relating it to enemies in space.
Sure.
But I believe a lot of this stuff probably could be countries like Russia, like China, like others, who are, you know, using now drones, using the kind of sophisticated weaponry that, you know, could very well be involved in a lot of these sightings. So I think that's the area to go to, very frankly, in order to identify what's happening.
All right. Chase, what do you got?
So I think his blink rate's through the roof from the beginning, and this is something that changed before we started watching this video. So you could see the subject start to come up and his blink rate started going up to ludicrous speed, to use some space terminology. And when he's saying there's a report that's coming out, we see galloping shoulders, kind of a single shrug on both shoulders, one at a time, which I would suggest is a doubt in the confidence of what he's saying, or lack of confidence. And when he's saying, I believe a lot of this stuff, there's a no head shake. This is one of those times we tell you that it doesn't always mean that. This is what it looks like. And I think when a person doesn't fully agree with what they're saying and they are saying no to what they're saying. And there is a whole lot of couching statements in true behavior panel fashion. I'm going to read them to you just real quick. We're going to say, basically, believe, probably, could be, I believe, like, others, kind of, could very well, I think. So nothing is for certain whatsoever in the entire statement. not even his confidence in his own opinions. And this is not in his baseline. If you've seen him, he's a big, powerful government official. He was the Secretary of Defense when I joined the military, and he doesn't do this. I've seen him in person, and I've never seen any behavior like this. So he was the Secretary of Defense. He was CIA. He was Joint Chiefs of Staff. He went around all areas of D.C., and this is not in his baseline. Scott?
All right, why don't I go last? So, Greg, why don't you go next?
Sure. Now, I'm going to get my opportunity to be on Ancient Aliens or something, I guarantee you, with what I'm about to say.
So, Unload it.
Guys, I'm going to give you quotes that you can
Hang
use.
Hang on. Okay.
Yeah, I need to go ahead. That before I let go. So, again, Chase, this guy's pretty contained and pretty calm, typically. He's a big, powerful man in his life. I met him when I was stationed at Dix. Together guy. What's interesting is when they bring up Russia and China, his blink rate is already fast, but then he gets his eyelids just fluttering like crazy. Then these three things together make me go, maybe there is something to this. When he says, I have never seen grief muscle, boom, grief muscle comes up. Why is there grief muscle when he says, I've never seen this? Then he does a nervous laugh. Then he looks down to the right. And then he goes back and he does lip compression. I'm just going to stop right there and say, I don't know why all of that happened. I'm not UFO hunting and saying, hey, he knows where the UFOs are. This is out of character. And those things indicate deception. Then when he gets back to the adversary stuff, his grief muscle comes up again. Something's up in this whole messaging and out of character for a guy who has been in the intelligence business.
Okay, well, that was a pretty interesting exchange, and I'm telling you, the entire hour and 40 minutes features a lot of that kind of back and forth amongst these Intel body language analysts. So it's very interesting, and like I say, I strongly recommend it, that you give it a look. I'll post the link. And basically, the entire time, nobody who's being asked these questions, whether it's Bush, or whether it's Clinton, whether it's Obama, whether it's the various former Intel chiefs, John Brennan, Panetta, who we saw, they hate talking about this subject. It's very interesting. These guys don't really draw any final conclusions as to why, but the whole thing is, like I said, it's why at the top of the show I called this the UFO stink bomb report, because people aren't liking the fact, powerful people aren't liking the fact that this subject is even on the table. I think that's pretty clear. And another thing that they go through, which we didn't get in that particular segment, is the actual comments that all these folks are making, the presidents and the Intel chiefs are making. They sort of have, they hit the same talking points. They do it, they use different words, they do it in their own style, but they're hitting the same talking points as if, you know, even though they're on the outside, they're basically getting briefed on this too, and they're pretty much being kept on the same page, either, by their own volition, they want to go along with the program, or, I don't think it's the case that they're being coerced in any way, but they're all on the same page with this, they're all on the same program. So it's very interesting to see what will be coming up. Hopefully within 2 weeks, I would say. Like I said, I don't expect anything, but maybe it's just as well, because this past week, since the NASA and the leak about what's going to be in the UFO report in the New York Times story, we've had a little bit less news this week, but it's given me a little bit of time to kind of spelunk around and find some different stuff to talk about. Again, getting the perspective from some folks who aren't UFO guys. They're not UFO guys. Very interesting to get their perspective. Very interesting to get the perspective of Harris and Weinstein, hearing what they have to say. With Weinstein, it's basically a lot of stuff on Twitter. So I really... you know, I really don't have anything. All I would say is go to Twitter and follow Eric Weinstein and see for yourself. But he's obviously on the pro-UFO page, or at least, you know, we need to know more about this page. So who knows what those everything those guys are hearing on the back channel. I would warn them both, don't be entirely trusting on what you hear in that back channel, but it does exist. Sometimes maybe it's a little exaggerated, but it's there, and it's a phenomenon, just like the UFO phenomenon. Obviously, the main thing that you want to find out more about is the UFO phenomenon itself, but it's always interesting how people go about the UFO phenomenon, and we'll analyze both, even if I would much prefer to be spending time talking about the former rather than the latter. So that's really about it. Short show. Enjoy your weekend, and maybe I'll be back next week with something else. There's enough going on, enough interesting stuff to talk about to fill maybe a half hour, 45 minutes, maybe not, and who knows? Maybe I'll turn up an interview. Can't say for sure. But I can assure you that my plans are, as soon as this UFO report comes out, to pour over it and get a show up on the air very, very quickly. Like I said, I'd be very shocked if it happens this coming week. I think it'll be on time right now. I don't think it'll get delayed either because of, you know, the media's on this story. They're talking about it. So that's about all I've got. You have a good weekend, and I'll be talking to you as soon as I've got something else to say. Bye-bye now.